There in the window is the woman. The same elderly woman that I saw in the hallway. She was in my brother's room.
Everyone loves a good ghost story, and we're about to add at least 10 more for you to tell around the campfire. Whether you believe in ghosts or not, the phrase, "there are some things you just can't explain," is pretty well known on this channel. I'm your ghostly host today, Rachel Fisher, and today we are counting down our top 10 real stories of celebrity hauntings. Coming in at number 10, we have Laura Linney and the haunting at the theater. First up at number 10, we have movie and theater legend Laura Linney. What I especially love about this story is that it happened at a theater, which would be considered a second home to many actors. While she was performing at Broadway's Belasco Theater, Linney claims with absolute certainty, and I quote, "it's absolutely haunted." This is her story and her appearance on The Late Late Show with James Corden. Linney says that she never believed in ghosts until this happened. She'd been told about ghosts in the theater, specifically one chorus girl who'd mysteriously passed away, and she scoffed, because why would she believe that? But legend says that the ghosts only come out during the final rehearsals of whatever show is being worked on at the time. She swept these tales under the rug, forgot about them, until one day while working on stage, she looked up to the upper balcony. She knew you could only access it from the outside and the doors were locked, but sitting in the front row was a woman in a blue dress with blonde hair. She looked away for a second, only to find the girl had disappeared when she looked back. Of course, that's what ghosts do. Laura Linney then says, and I quote, "I went to the house manager and I said, 'Joe, I think I saw a ghost.' And he went, 'Male or female?' I said, 'Female.' And he went, 'Blue dress, blonde hair.'" Ooh, say it with me. Ooh. Number 9, Matthew McConaughey and Madame Bleu. This next one comes from Academy Award winner Matthew McConaughey. During an interview for his movie Ghosts of Girlfriends Past, McConaughey has the perfect story about a ghost named Madame Bleu. Now, Matthew says that before this, he's not one to say that ghosts are real or aren't real, but when he started feeling this presence of a woman who soon took on the name Madame Bleu, McConaughey stood his ground and said, "You can move around all you want, but I ain't going anywhere." Typical McConaughey. The woman would apparently hang around a certain room in his house, and even if he didn't tell his guests, they would know something was up. Check this clip out.
"And for weeks, everyone that came over the house said the same things. So there's someone down in that hall, there's someone down in that. I said, I know. And I'm not one to say I believe or don't believe in ghosts, but people kept coming. I would not tell them."
Matthew goes on to say that eventually she cooled down, and instead of making the room she inhabited unwelcomed, everyone who visited suddenly loved that room. I mean, it is impossible to resist the southern charm. But this story begs the question, do you believe in ghosts? Because it'd be a lot cooler if you did. Number 8, LaToya Jackson, haunted by Michael? If you're one of the people who believes that Michael Jackson is still alive, then you might not be entirely wrong. He is alive in some ways, according to his sister, LaToya Jackson. LaToya says that she often feels the presence of her brother in their home, describing that, and I quote, "You feel something thick behind you or around you, and you're wondering, you don't see anything, but you feel a presence," she said. Unquote. "I know what you're thinking, that could be anyone or anything, but the story gets weirder. One of the security guards in the home said that he heard tap dancing in what used to be Michael's old room. According to Toya, Michael used to tap dance for 2 hours every Sunday, but when they went up there, though they still heard tapping, there was no one there." LaToya also notes that the dog barks at the window in Michael's room every single night at the exact same time. Weird. Coming in at number 7, Miley Cyrus and the Haunted Bakery Hotel. While Miley was touring Europe, she'd often need a home base that she could return to, logically. The perfect place was initially an apartment she had in London, right across the street from Harrods. But she had to move because it was haunted. It used to be an old bakery, but then she started having these really vivid, crazy nightmares. And you're thinking, stress from the tour? Maybe. Well, one night she heard her sister scream in the shower. The water was suddenly scalding because somehow the nozzle had been flipped to hot, not by Noah. Every now and then though, she'd see at the corner of her eye a little boy sitting on the bathroom counter swinging his feet. Obviously, her mother didn't believe her until her aunt said, and I quote Miley quoting her aunt, "I had no idea what happened, but I left the apartment and I came back and all the doors and windows were open. I locked the apartment." Unquote. It wasn't long until they decided to move, and Miley swears she will never stay there again. Number 6, Demi Lovato and her best friend forever.
"And then I saw a little girl in my closet. Just weird, just throwing it out there. I totally believe in ghosts." Yeah. "After that, there's no way I can."
The actress and singer revealed on the Mac at Night radio show in 2011 that she totally believes in ghosts. And with this story, I mean, who can blame her? She even goes ghost hunting and claims that the house in Texas she lived in is haunted by the spirit of a little girl from the 1800s named Emily, who she saw in her closet. But she's not the only one. Her entire family has had experiences that they just can't explain. From people appearing to be in the kitchen, to socks being laid out on the bed, to children running around upstairs, but Demi and her sister were both fast asleep. A bunch of stuff. Then there's this story. Demi's friend Tucker came over to her house, and as they were watching a movie, the laptop in the kitchen turned on and started playing a whole different film. As Tucker was texting a friend, Demi says, and I quote, "Tucker texted a friend saying, I think this house is haunted. A movie just turned on by itself, and there was a glitch in his phone that kept texting him back the word, definitely over and over again. That happened about 30 times, unquote. I'm on board with this one, you guys. Demi is definitely haunted. That makes sense. And apparently her mom says that her and this little girl named Emily, she used to call her Victoria, they were best friends when they were little. Creepy. I guess that little girl's little forever. Coming in at number 5, Keanu Reeves and the woman with the missing legs. Keanu Reeves is convinced that he saw a ghost when he was a young child after moving to New York City. We all know children have a kind of openness to the ghost world. Why we lose it as adults, who knows? Maybe it's because reality sucks. In an interview with Jimmy Kimmel Live in 2014, Reeves confesses that he saw a ghost. While Reeves was a little kid and in a way thought it was cool and easily accepted it, when he looked over at his nanny and saw her horror-stricken face, it was then that he realized it was real. Nope, Keanu wasn't just a glitch in the Matrix, that was an actual ghost. Number 4, Allison Hannigan and the Friendly Ghost. Next up, we have Buffy the Vampire Slayer alumni, Allison Hannigan, who also is too familiar with the occult. Though she doesn't think the ghost who lives in her home in LA died there, she doesn't mind having him as a roommate. He's nice. A law in LA states that if someone did die in a home, then the real estate agent has to disclose the information. But Hannigan in 2003 said, quote, "He's very friendly," unquote. Even one of her friends once saw him and said, "I don't mean to alarm you, but I just saw a man follow us out of the house." To which Hannigan replied, "Well, at least he's gentlemanly. He let us go first." Allison even spotted him once as a silhouette in the doorway of the bathroom and thought it was her fiance until she looked beside her and saw that her fiance was sleeping. Considering her role in Buffy, it's no surprise that Hannigan would be so accustomed to members of the supernatural and even wanted to put a chalkboard up so the ghost could write their name down. I wonder if he ever did. Coming in at number 3, we have Megan Fox and Ghosts for Breakfast. So many people speculate, including Megan, that she's actually clairvoyant, which is kind of cool. She strangely predicted events for her friends and stated in an interview with MTV News in 2014 that she does in fact believe in everything, aliens, ghosts, you name it. One story in particular that highlights her belief in spirits while she was staying in a multi-room hotel. She ordered breakfast for 7:30, but at 7, she and her nanny both heard someone come in with a tray and pour coffee. Half hour later, she enters the room at 7:30 and there's not a slice of toast to be found. Right then, the doorbell rings and it's room service with breakfast for the first time. It would have been dismissed as a dream if it was just Megan that heard it, but the fact that the nanny heard it convinced Megan to this day that they must have been visited by a ghost. Number 2, Dan Aykroyd and the Cuddly Ghost. Yes, you got that right. Legendary Ghostbuster and comedian Dan Aykroyd has actually been haunted by ghosts several times. From the typical doors opening and closing by themselves to objects moving around, even his staff experienced ghostly touches when no one was around. But the ghost, or ghost plural, wanted to get a lot closer to Dan, even crawling into bed with him. The story goes as follows, and I quote, "I was alone in the house and decided to take a nap. I closed the door to the bedroom, but didn't lock it. I woke up in this kind of trance where you don't know whether you're sleeping or not. It's what the abductee feels when he's being taken. I saw the door open and I rolled over and looked at the bed and saw the depression in the mattress, like somebody was getting in there. And I thought, I'm just gonna roll over and snuggle up next to it," unquote. So he basically spooned a ghost. Who are you gonna call, Dan? Who are you gonna call? And lastly, number 1, Ariana Grande and the Gates of Hell. In 2013, Ariana Grande recounts an experience she had when asked during an interview with Complex if she'd ever seen an alien. The answer was no, but she definitely definitely encountered ghosts. While in Kansas City, she visited a haunted castle, excited by the potential thrill of an encounter with a ghost. But right after, she went to Stull Cemetery, one of the most terrifying places in the world. According to Grande, the Pope won't even fly over it, as it's said to be home to one of seven gates of hell. According to Grande, she said, and I quote, "I felt this sick, overwhelming feeling of negativity over the whole car, and we smelled sulfur, which is the sign of a demon. And there was a fly in the car randomly, which is another sign of a demon. I was like, this is scary, let's leave. I rolled down the window before we left and said, we apologize, we didn't mean to disrupt your peace. Then I took a picture and there are three super distinct faces in the picture. They're faces of textbook demons," unquote. The next day she tried to send the pic to her manager but couldn't send the file due to the fact that the size was 666 megabytes. She deleted the pictures to ward off the evil after feeling a negative presence haunting her in her hotel room. I don't know guys, so what do you think friends? Are these stories enough to make you a believer, or do you have a story of your own that haunts you to this day? If you do, you know we want to hear it, so let us know in the comments. Plus, like and subscribe for more stories to keep you up at night. My name's been Rachel Fisher, and I've been your host. And until next time, stay scared.